شراب الحب يعرف بالمذاق، وما كل السقاط له بساق. شراب الحب يعرف بالمذاق، وما كل السقاط له بساق. أحب الله.
ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أفضل المرسلين محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن اتبع هداه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. ثم أما بعد، I want to share with you inshallah in those few minutes about the topic, and this topic we need it in the present time, especially when the Muslim Ummah going through hardship and calamity. And we need to be trust, have complete trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to depend only in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that is at-tawakkul. And the translation of at-tawakkul in English, with some people, it depend or trust, is more than that. When the tawakkul, that تفوض الأمر لله سبحانه وتعالى, meaning but all the matters in hand of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. You do your part, you do your job, you do what Allah سبحانه وتعالى order you to do, then you leave everything and the result to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Just like our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, our Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم in الهجرة, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he took all the steps, he make a plan, complete beautiful plan, and then he hide inside that small cave. But the people of Quraysh, they find out some trace, foot steps, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and they follow the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم to the mountain, all the way to the cave where is the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم hide inside the cave with Abu Bakr as-Siddiq رضي الله تعالى عنه. Now the people of Quraysh outside the cave, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he took all the steps for protection, to protect himself and protect his companion Abu Bakr as-Siddiq رضي الله تعالى عنه. But they are there and they're looking for the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, of course. And their mission is to kill the Prophet. Their mission is to kill the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. But the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, when he took all the steps, he put the trust, depend only in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one else. And what happened? The people of Quraysh there, Abu Bakr as-Siddiq in that critical situation, whispering to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, خَيَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهِ لَوْ نَظَرَ أَحَدُهُمْ تَحْتَ قَدَمَيْهِ لَرَآنَا. If somebody will look under his feet, he will see us. He will look under his feet, look at his feet, at his toes, he will see us. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam smile and he told Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, يا Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, ما ظنك باثنين الله ثالثهما. What do you think about two sitting here inside the cave, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the third. لا تحزن إن الله معنا. Don't be sad, Allah is with us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah At-Tawbah, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا ثاني اثنين إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه إن الله معنا فأنزل الله سكينته عليه. الله عز وجل says إلا تنصروه فقد نصره الله. If you're not going to give him victory, Allah will give him victory. Allah will give victory. إذ أخرجه الذين كفروا ثاني اثنين إذ هما بالغار. The people, the kuffar, they run after the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and they are inside that cave, small cave. ثانية اثنين ثانية they are two, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with them, with his power, with his mercy, with his authority. إذ هما في الغار إذ يقول لصاحبه لا تحزن إن الله معنا. Telling his companion, telling his friend, لا تحزن, don't be sad, Allah is with us. فأنزل الله سكينته عليه. الله عز وجل هي السكينة. سكينة وأيده بجنود لم تروها. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى supporting with the soldiers you didn't see those soldiers. See, وجعل كلمة الذين كفروا السفلى وكلمة الله هي العليا. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى make the word, the statement or the mission of the kuffar down. And the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is up. Is up. If you just think about this situation, Allah, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he take his steps. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he make a plan. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, depend in Allah. Trust in Allah. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give him the victory. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he won. And the people of Christ left. And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam left after that. So tawakkul Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you put all your trust, all your mission, all your demand, everything in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will support you and remove the harm from you, from about you. And our Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, also Ibrahim alayhi salam, and you know the story, I'm sure sharing the story to comprehend, to live under the shade of this story, especially what our Muslim Ummah, all the Muslim Ummah going through right now, the hardship and the calamity. And Namrud, the king of Iraq in that time, he found out that Ibrahim alayhi salam, the one he destroyed those idols, the temple, and they brought Ibrahim alayhi salam, and his young man, Fata, Fata, that's mean young, he's not even 20 years old. And he destroyed those idols to prove to the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is one, Allah is the creator. And they ordered that, the king ordered everybody to bring a stick, dry stick wood, to make a huge fire. And he made a huge, huge fire. Big fire. The Ibn Kathir, the scholar Ibn Kathir said, if the bird flew in the top of this fire, will drop dead, will burn. Okay, so now Ibrahim alayhi salam watching, observing the fire. He was tied up with a chain. He was a chained, Ibrahim alayhi salam. So when Jibreel alayhi salam came and he saw Ibrahim alayhi salam in this situation, قال ألك حاجة? He said to him, do you want something? Do you need anything? And Ibrahim alayhi salam said, أما منك فلا. If from you, I don't want anything. If from you, فأما من الله فحسبي الله ونعم الوكيل. حسبي الله, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala support me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is complete sufficient for me. You look at the fire, the angel of rain. The angel of rain came as he wanted me to send the rain. And Ibrahim alayhi salam told the same thing. From you I don't want anything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient for me. The angel of wind came is the same statement and the same thing. same thing. So Ibrahim alayhi salam defending Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So in Namrud, he ordered his people to throw Ibrahim alayhi salam in the middle of the fire. Throw him because they cannot be close to the fire. Qadaf, that means throw, just like you throw a rock. Throw Ibrahim inside the fire, the middle of the huge, huge fire. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he do what Jibreel. He didn't want the angel of rain. He didn't want the angel of wind or any angels. He want Allah. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, during when the strong Ibrahim alayhi salam in the fire, Allah give order to the fire. Ya naru kuni bardan wa salaman ala Ibrahim. Ya nar, be cold and peace about Ibrahim alayhi salam. So with Ibrahim alayhi salam, in his way to the fire, Allah gave the fire the order, the fire become cold, and Ibrahim came in the middle of the fire for days. Fire, I'm talking about fire. What is the characteristics of the fire to burn? Burn. Any fire, small fire or big fire, it will burn the person. Have a match and put the match for seconds on the fire of the match, it will burn your hand. Imagine that a huge fire, Ibrahim alayhi salam was in the middle of the fire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered the fire. Ya naru kuni bardan, oh nar, or fire, be bardan, cold, wa salaman, and peace upon Ibrahim alayhi salam. And that's exactly what happened. That's exactly what happened. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved Ibrahim when Ibrahim alayhi salam depend and trust only Allah. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what is our mission, my dear brothers and sisters, just to think about our situation with the Muslim Ummah right now. This is the trust we need. This is our mission, is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You live to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you die worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you get the reward from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Muslim Ummah suffering a lot. Now we go back to him. To whom? To the one who created us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And sooner or later, we'll go back home. Sooner or later, we'll go back home. Back home is the Jannah. When Adam came from, this is our place. Our land, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Ibrahim alayhi salam, that statement when he says, Hasbi Allah wa ni'mal wakil, it's happened to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And what happened? In the Battle of Uhud, as all of you know, the Muslims lost 70 of the Muslims. 70 of the Sahaba. And then the people, the Sahaba went to Medina. 70 of them got killed, and most of them got injured. Most of them got injured. But still our Prophet said, let's follow them. Only the people injured and the people tired from that war. So let's follow them. And they listened to the Prophet and they followed them to the area called Hamra al-Asad. Area called Hamra al-Asad. And then Abu Sufyan, he started to send messages to our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That means the people of Quraysh coming to kill you all. The people of Quraysh coming to kill you all. And Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned that in Surah Al Imran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسُ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمَعُوا لَكُمْ فَخْشَوْهُمْ. He said, الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسُ. The people told them, send messages. The people of Quraysh, they are prepared for you to come and kill you. فَخْشَوْهُمْ, that be aware, be afraid of them. And what happened? فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا. The Sahaba become more believer. Allah will give the victory. وَقَالُوا, and they said, حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ. They said, حَسْبُنَا اللَّهُ, Allah is our sufficiency. نعم الوكيل, we trust and depend in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Most of them injured and tired, cannot fight. And number is small number, and the Quraysh, they are, they killed 70 of the Sahaba, and they are stronger. But they said the same statement. Well, our Prophet Muhammad, our Prophet Ibrahim عليه السلام, حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. That was the answer. In Surah Al-Anfal, فَانْقَلَبُوا بِنِعْمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ وَفَضْلٍ لَمْ يَمْسَسْهُمْ سُوءٌ وَاتَّبَعُوا رِضْوَانَ اللَّهِ. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. فزادهم إيمانا. They become more stronger, more believer. And they said, حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. Allah sufficient for us. Allah is the vision and we depend in Allah. Then فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله. Allah عز وجل give them ni'mah, favors and fadl. They give him victory. After they lost the war in the Battle of Uhud, and the number is small, now the number is smaller. Now the number is more smaller, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them the victory in the area called Hamra al-Asad. Why? Because they depend in Allah. They depend in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's what we need. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase our iman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase our taqwa. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala increase our belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah is the sufficient for all of us. The mother of Musa, Musa alayhi salam, Musa alayhi salam, when the people of Israel, the Israelites, they left Egypt, he gathered everybody from the people of Yaqub, all the tribes, and they left Egypt because the Pharaoh started to kill the children and kill the women and kill everybody. He killed all of them. And then they ran with Musa and Harun alayhi salam. And then the Pharaoh, they found out, as you know in the story before, they found out and they run after them to kill all of them. Subhanallah. And then and they're running and they said, the people of Musa, they now remember, imagine the picture. They're facing the sea, they are facing the sea, and behind them, Fir'aun. Behind them, the Pharaoh and the soldiers of Pharaoh. What they said, that's it, it's over. قالوا إنا لمدركون. That's it. We will be killed, all of us. But Musa alayhi salam, he have the trust in Allah. Even in this situation, the ocean is there, and the people of Pharaoh behind them, they came to kill them, and this is that's it. Musa alayhi salam قال كلا كلا, that means there is no way. Absolutely not. إِنَّ مَعَيَ رَبِّي سَيَهْدِينَ. Allah is with me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide me. Allah is with me and Allah will guide me. Subhanallah. And the moment Musa saying that statement, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Musa alayhi salam, اضرب بعصاك البحر. With your staff, with your stick, strike the ocean, strike the sea. And when the moment he struck the sea, that sea, the water, homogeneous liquid, start to make roads and katold al-azim, just like a mountains. Mountains, that water make roads. Every tribe of them, they went in one road. And Musa alayhi salam enter road, is dry land. And the water standing without anything holding the water, and then they start to enter to other side of the river, of the beach, to the other side of the ocean, of the sea. The other side of the sea, and they reach. And the Pharaoh, he saw those people running in through those roads, he followed that people. And now they are the people of Musa alayhi salam on the other side of the sea. And the Pharaoh is following them. And what? They are still in danger. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to Musa, strike again the ocean. And when he struck the sea again, the water become like regular. There is no more roads. and the people of Pharaoh, and Pharaoh himself sunk, and they died, all of them. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the body of Pharaoh, Ramses, and all the way, and they took the body, and the dead body, the one he used to say, I am God. Now he is dead. And anybody can go to Egypt in the museum and he can see that body. Still the body is there until today. That is the lesson for the people. That even Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is a lesson for the people to see that when he say, I am God, look what happened, he's dead, sunk inside the sea. May Allah protect us from that. Remember what Musa said? Musa said, Kalla. No way. Impossible. Kalla, not la. La does mean no in Arabic language. La does mean no. But kalla. كأن لا يريك. لا كلا. That means there is no way the Pharaoh will come to kill us or to reach us. The Pharaoh will be defeated. And this is exactly what happened. That's exactly what happened. They die, all of them. The victory from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Musa alayhi salam said كلا, that he know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save him and save all of them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save all of them. That's exactly what we have to do, my dear brothers and sisters. In this situation, what we do is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with us. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with you, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with you, no one will be against you. No one will be against you. Our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith, he said, لو أنكم توكلتم على الله حق توكله. If you depend in Allah, the true depend in Allah سبحانه وتعالى. لرزقكم كما يرزق الطير. He will provide you just like Allah سبحانه وتعالى provide the birds. Just like Allah سبحانه وتعالى provide the birds. How تغدو خماصة. In the morning, the birds will have complete empty stomach. Complete empty stomach. And the end of the day, the birds will have a complete full stomach. Who provide the birds? The Razzaq. But they depend in Allah. They trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's exactly what we are talking about. Let me tell you a story. Sulaiman alayhi salam, Prophet Sulaiman alayhi salam, he told Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Rabb, I want to have something of the creation to take care of. To take care of. And I want ant, only an ant. See what ant to take care of. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Sulaiman, you can't. Because you need somebody to support you. I say, Ya Rabbi, give me this a chance. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave him a chance. That small ant. Sulaiman alayhi salam asked the ant, how many barley, piece, seed of barley you eat for the whole entire year? And the ant says, two. Two pieces for the whole entire year. And Musa, Sulaiman alayhi salam, he brought the barley, two seeds, and the ant in the jar and water, and he put these two seeds to that ant. To that ant. That ant ate one seed, one piece for the whole entire year. Then Sulaiman alayhi salam came and he saw the seed, only one seed left, and the ant ate one. And he asked the ant, I ask you, how many seeds you want? How many seeds you want for the whole entire year? You said two. I gave you two, but you ate one. He said, yes. I used to eat two, but now I ate one. I ate one because I know you supporting me. You providing me, I ate one because maybe you will forget me. But when I, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He will never forget me. That's why I used to eat two. And I know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will provide even more. So Allah is the provider. You provide me two, but I know you, maybe you'll forget me. Maybe you will die. I will die too if I eat two. When I know that you are the supporter, I eat one. But I know when Allah is the supporter, I eat two. Because I know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will support me more. Yes, and remember, we are in Muharram, the month of Muharram. And remember Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam. Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salam, when he took Hajar to that desert. Desert. You know what this desert is? There is no water. There is no human being. There is no animals even. That especially in the area, there is not even an animals. And Ibrahim alayhi salam, he put his wife and his son, the only son, in the middle of the desert. He put both of them in the middle of the desert. Nothing there. Not even animals. Wallah, not even animals there. There's nothing there. Subhanallah. But Ibrahim alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salam left and his wife behind him. And his wife behind him. Say, Ibrahim, you leave us here for whom? You leave us here for whom? There's nothing there. And Ibrahim have no answer. And Ibrahim, he cannot even look. Ibrahim alayhi salam, he cannot even look at her. Subhanallah. Out, because if you look at her, he will feel love and sympathy again. He cannot even look at his son, the only son after 89 years. Leaving him now in the middle of the desert alone. And she asked him, Ibrahim, you leave us for whom here? And as you know in the story, Ibrahim alayhi salam, he didn't reply for 3 times. Then she asked him one question. Allah amaraka bidalik? Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order you to do so? To leave us here in the middle of the desert? And Ibrahim alayhi salam said yes. And she said, idhab, go. Go. Allah will never waste us or leave us alone here. Just go. And Ibrahim left. He left his wife and his son with some dates and some water and nothing else. La ilaha illallah. In our criteria of thinking, this is haram. In our criteria of thinking, it doesn't make sense. But the criteria of Ibrahim alayhi salam makes a lot of sense. In the criteria of Hajar alayhi salam, makes a lot of sense. Why? Because this order from whom? From Allah, from Al-Razzaq, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. She said, go to her husband. Go. Allah will never waste us here. But the water finished. And the dates, what she has some dates finished. And her chest dry. There is no more milk. And the baby start to cry. The baby start to suffer and cry. La ilaha illallah. And then she'll start to run to see where is water. She went to Safa, as you know, and she looked and she saw a mirage. A mirage. She thought that is water. She ran to that mountain from Safa to Marwa. Marwa, small, another mountain. She found no water. But when she looked again, she looked in the Safa area, there is water. She ran to Safa area, as you know in the story. But her eyes toward her son, toward the baby. And she found After seven times, Bismillah, she heard a blast, a sound, a gross sound. And she ran to that place. Her son, where is her son? And actually when she struck, she heard the sound, she said, Sah. This means she gave attention. There is no one there. Listen. And she went to her son, and under the feet of Ismail, alayhi salam, she found the water and she started to surround the water and she says, Zam, Zam, Zam. This means that we call it Zam Zam. Because that what she said, Zam, that means collecting the water together. And Jibreel alayhi salam told her, this Allah will never waste or leave us you alone here. In that moment, in that time, in the same period of time, the best of the Arab, the best of the genuine Arab in Yemen, they used to live in a world, some kind of water called Sad Ma'rib, the dam of Ma'rib. And that destroyed, that dam is destroyed. And the best of the Arab, they came, كُلْجِرْهُمْ, they came toward that area. They know there is no water there. They know there is no water, no human being. But they saw birds flying up. And they said, the birds all over flying, if somebody did, oh, there is water. If there is water. And they found water, and they found the mother of Ismail, and Ismail alayhi salam there. And they make an agreement with her to live there with them and to take the water, to sell the water for them. And they lived there. And Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salam grow up among those nations, the best of the nation of the Arab, of the Arab. That is the tawakkul ala Allah. Depend in Allah. Trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No one else. No one else. If you have this kind of belief, if you have this kind of trust, no one will harm you. Even if they try. We think we are in calamity and hardship. Any calamity or hardship is a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at me in this place here. I'm in the hospital right now. For me, or for maybe a lot of people think, look at him, very poor, sitting in pain, all the time in pain. But Allah did have a wisdom different from my thinking. My thinking, to get a cure. I want to get a cure. I want to go home for 2 weeks now in the hospital. I really want to go home. Too much for me. It's a punishment for some people thinking. But to think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has his plan, and I have my thinking. And my thinking always wrong, and the plan of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always right. Allah is the planner. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is al-hadi. Yunus alayhi salam, he left his people, he gave up. He gave up from his people, he don't want his people anymore. And he left the Nineveh, the city of the, and he left to the sea. He want to go to some other people to give hidayah, to give guidance, to guide the people to the Islam. And then, you know, the story with Yunus alayhi salam, Jonah alayhi salam, he was, they throw him inside the ocean. And the whale take Yunus alayhi salam, the whale, huge fish. And they, inside the fish, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order that fish or that whale not to harm or hurt Yunus alayhi salam. He sit inside that whale, and the whale went down and down and down, darkness and darkness, dhulumat. And Yunus alayhi salam said, see, La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu min al-zalimin. لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين. That's it. This is the only dua. The angel hearing this dua, but they didn't know this dua coming from where. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. فأنجيناه من اليم. Allah has to give the answer. فأنجيناه من اليم وكذلك ننجي المؤمنين. We save him from that trouble. We save him from that calamity and hardship. And we're going to save every person in the calamity or hardship. That's what I have to say. In this calamity, in this hardship, just like Yunus alayhi salam, La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni kuntu tadh-dhalimin. La ilaha illa anta subhanaka inni كنت من الطالبين. We're talking about the best of the nations, the best of the people, the prophets and messengers. And they went through this kind of calamity. What about us? What about me and you? We went through calamity and hardship. We think we are in calamity and hardship, but they went actually those best of the nation, best of the people, more through more calamity and hardship. But Allah in the end gave victory to those people. That's what we need, brothers and sisters. My message to all of you. And this for me, the message is for me myself. Sometimes in this place, I start to cry. I said, why is I'm here? I didn't supposed to be out giving da'wah with my family, with my kids. I always think of every night, I think about this. In fact, every moment I think about this. But you know, Allah is the best planner. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only planner. Planner, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أنا أريد وأنت تريد. I want something and you want something else. But Allah do whatever He wants. And that's always right. And our decision always wrong compared to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I leave you now. في أمان الله and think about my words. Depend in Allah. Trust in Allah. He will provide you just like provide the birds. In the morning, with completely empty stomach. The end of the day, you have completely full stomach. Allah is الرزاق. توكل على الله. Depend in Allah. Be with Allah and say, La ilaha illallah, Muhammad Rasulullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.